Alright, she's just responding to that. Alright, she's just responding to that. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. This is Stas Varence, and welcome to GWA Saturday Night Wrestling. Joining me tonight, as always, my co-host and good friend. Say hello to Carter, everyone. Say hello to Carter, everyone.
We can't hear you. They're not saying hello.
Hi.
Oh, I can hear you, obviously.
Okay. And I can hear you.
Right, but we can't hear the audience.
Wait a minute. Oh, wait. Never mind. I was looking at the wrong desktop audio. Yeah. It's audio one. That's you. I was like, wait a minute. That better not be broken again.
An RIP plug two. While we're on the subject.
Anyways, tonight we've got a big show for you tonight. First and foremost, we've got the start of a tag team tournament to crown new GWA tag team champions. And this move is largely in part Ortega's way of just stopping, but preventing another free for all from breaking out between three of GWA's top teams right now, the Brawling Brutes, La Grenouille, and the Canadian Crusher Chase Ford, and the Duncan Brothers, Duncan Fist and Duncan Destroyer. Nobody's framing you, Kisala. But since you're in here, keep an eye out for bots while the show is happening. I thank you for that. We of course also have week four of the GWA Junior Heavyweight Championship Tournament. Oh, well, that was strange. I was looking at the chat, and I'm seeing in the moderator section, Kisala Branford. You didn't by any chance just perhaps left yourself in my Discord since Wednesday, did you? That would be mad funny, actually. Because Wednesday we did the the Disgaea 4, and now we've got tonight's stream, and yeah, weird. But tonight we've got. We've got 1-2 Kane taking on 3-0 Duke Fed. Kane looking possibly to try to not only score another win, but to break Duke Fed's current win streak that he's got going. Also, we've got El Bo, who is currently 2-1. Going up against Akira Tozawa, also 2-1. So someone's going to pull ahead tonight. Elbow, a little miffed right now. He was hoping for possibly a 3-0 against... only to have that curbed by John Knox last week. We've also got Homicide taking on Ronin tonight. Homicide 1-2, hoping to pick up another win. Ronin another 3-0 Jazzman going to take on Wait a minute. Am I looking at the wrong things? I think I'm looking at the wrong things. Or maybe I'm looking at too. I was going a little too far. We also have in the A block, Jazzman taking on Ada. Ada has yet to pick up a win, but he's hoping to start making up for lost time. Jazz so far only has one win to his name. But hoping to pull that to 2-2. Also tonight we've got Pac taking on the Nacho Man. Hijo del Vikingo will take on John Knox. Ace Austin will take on Mamori Takashi. Oh, you're at work. Okay, no problem. And finally we've got Orange Cassidy taking on El Desperado tonight. Orange Cassidy, also one of those at 0-3. He's hoping. Well, actually, Orange Cassidy and El Desperado, both of them at 0-3. One of them is going home with a win tonight, folks. We also got the first round of our junior heavyweight tournament, where we've got the Brawling Brutes taking on the Lucha Brothers tonight. And in our main event, GWA World Heavyweight Champion Revenzo will be taking on Kenno. No, and everybody and anyone who's familiar with Kenno knows him as the leader of Kongo over in Japan. Currently, hearing good things about Kenno and Kongo in over in Pro Super Japan, but let's see how he stacks up tonight. So, without further ado, let's get the first match going. Mizuki will be handling Mizuki will be handling referee duties for this tournament, and we begin with Kane with our first A block match, Kane versus Duke Fed. And a match like this, how do you think this may affect Duke if he should suffer a loss tonight in this game? Considering that Duke is currently sitting high at 3-0 right now.
Oh, man.
How bad do you think that loss might thorn him off leading towards the end as we come up to basically the second half of the tournament here?
Now, 4-1 is still sitting pretty. I mean, 3-1 instead of 4-0. Excuse my math there. It's still good. It's just not untouchable like he is now.
Mm-hmm. And a win for Kane would bring him up 2-2, and that would. Could keep that going, that may be able to help him. But then what about some of those like Ata, Orange Cassidy, like who are currently at 0-3? Do you see any hope of them at being able to play any sort of catch up if they were to start going on a win streak starting this week?
Well, that'd be pretty exciting. I think there's definitely a possibility. that one of them could end up going to 4-3 or something. Just missed that kick. Oh, fisherman buster.
Ah! Oh, going back and forth these kicks. Oh, he drops the elbow square on Kane's back.
That was a solid elbow. Oh, on his head again.
Oh! Oh, caught the leg, stripped him down, rolls him over, drops the knee on the back.
Whoa, display of raw strength from Kane there.
Duke responds with a head scissors. Kane kicks him off, though. Oh, roll up, cover, one. Nope. Oh! Right at the last minute, Kane ducks the punch. Ah! Cover. Ah! One. Nope. Yeah. Right to the neck. And there's that good old-fashioned Duke-fed ground and pound right there. Oh, Kane with a roll-up. Two!
That submission.
Kane throws him off. Oh! The ladder's in. Goes through from the ropes.
Oh! Another suplex off the ground.
Oh, and a super kick from Fed. Rolls him up, cover. One, two. Oh! Off the ropes! Nails him with the wheel kick! Pulls him up, cover! One! Two!
No blows.
Yeah. Ooh, nice counter.
Ooh, Duke Fett had him dead to rights there. Kane did not see that coming.
Back and forth they go.
Duke Fett is getting tired.
Ooh.
Athletic display.
Oh, counter. Down goes Kane. Woo. Oh. Up top. Cross body, but nope, he was in the ropes.
Yeah.
Ooh. Picks up Duke. Gets him with a cutter.
Boom. Yeah. Misses a roundhouse. Lands a catch suplex.
Kane off the ropes. Gets him with the drop kick.
Full rotation drop kick.
And another Sigori bomber from Duke. Catches him with that clothesline. Oh!
Got the submission finally.
Duke goes up to 8 points. What a win for Duke Fed.
Yeah, solid win. He really had...
Hey, look who's finally here at the start of a show. Welcome, Hyper.
Tournament has not been fertile ground for Kane.
No, it has not. All right, coming up next. We've got Akira Tozawa taking on El Bo in the B block. Oh, looks like Tozawa's pulling out the ninja gear this time.
Interesting choice.
Here we go. So, Gomboy, what do you got your money on?
Ooh, Tozawa starting with the chops.
Here come the elbows.
Suplex by elbow. Ooh, Tozawa's not taking it lying down.
Off the ropes. Ooh! By the way, Convoy, I want to get your thoughts. What do you think about Bruno Sammartino being in WWE 2K23?
Viva Mexico!
And Carter, what do you think about that?
About what?
Bruno Sammartino being in WWE 2K23.
I mean, he was a legend dating back to WWF times. Yeah. So I guess it makes sense.
I think so, yeah.
Oh, misses the elbow. Hits that one.
Ooh! You know what I would honestly would like to see in a 2K game? Steiner Brothers. The Steiner Brothers, Rick and Scott. I'm talking like old school, and like early 90s Steiners.
That would be great.
And obviously, possibly also a Big Papa Pump version of Scott. But I would love the early 90s freaking like college wrestling Steiners with the singlets and whatnot. And then put it with Braun Breaker as the Steiner family. See, that would be awesome to be able to do. Oh yeah.
Oh. Solid punch to the face.
Oh. Goes around. Flying elbow. What? Oh, wait. Ooh.
Yeah.
Oh.
Trading elbows goes in elbow's favor. Snap suplex lays that elbow.
Cover. One. Two.
Not quite. Close him up. Let's do it.
Not quite.
Almost got him. The crowd is very excited over these two near falls back to back.
Yep.
Elbow in the face.
Oh! Oh, nice bridge cover. One, two.
Oh! Oh!
Tozawa picks up the win. Damn, Elbow went from having a win streak going to back-to-back-to-back losses, and that puts Akira up to 6 points.
Well, I guess the new gear paid off.
Apparently!
Elbow didn't have an answer to those suplexes once he started throwing them out at escalated, and
escalated is an understatement.
Yes, indeed.
One second, I gotta adjust my rankings here. But yeah, solid win for Tozawa, ladies and gentlemen. All right, we've got West. Oh, by the way, Convoy, out of the referees here at the GWA, do you have any favorites? That was Mizuki from Big League Japan. And coming up next is a self-proclaimed best damn ref in the GWA, Wes Castle. Coming to the ring is Mickey Martin. We've seen him before. He's known to be an associate of Gold Lightning from on occasion. He helped him out at one point. He's coming out for his first solo match. Let's see how he does. And oh no! Oh dear God! Is this man? Will this man's bloodlust be satisfied, or will he not be satisfied until he can finally get his hands on the title?
Was nothing. The demon establishing his dominance early. Headbutts and a chomp on Black. Oh. Takes him down.
And Martin uses size to overpower the demon.
Those headbutts, but Demon Black is not amused. Yeah. Oh. Oh, we missed. Took him down.
Oh! Oh!
Training chops. A lot of moxie under this mohawk.
That's true.
Takes him down again.
Oh, roll him up. Cover. One.
That can do it.
Nope.
Shoulder breaker.
Martin,
and another headbutt.
Martin is on the offense.
Oh no.
Oh! Tombstone pile driver.
Right out of nowhere. That can do it.
Yeah.
Oh, misses the kick. Eats one. Hits him again. Can his head take this much punishment?
Damn, not even a one count. Ooh, a DDT for Ricky Martin.
Oh, into a stretch muffler.
Don't forget that tonight we've got back-to-back wrestling cruise night. After the GWA ends, head over to WrestleCast Radio at 11 p.m. tonight. For Pro Wrestling Summit. So don't forget that, ladies and gentlemen. Oh!
Knocking down. Might do it. It's another shoulder break.
Oh!
Lands a big roundhouse kick.
drops Black into DDT, but Black is right back up on his feet like nothing happened.
Yay!
Slams him into the corner.
To the shoulder breaker.
Lever, one, two.
This might be it. Oh, he got out of that somehow.
TD chops. Yeah, I know, right? Oh, Jesus.
Going for that shoulder.
And another stretch muffler. Desperate, he's just throwing everything he can at the demon.
Oh!
Oh! Wes is down.
Oh!
Oh, look at my camel clutch.
Oh, he got to the ropes in time.
Off the road. Oh, nope. Oh!
Taking that.
Jesus Christ.
Power slam.
Cover one, two.
Give up. Give up.
we got out of that somehow. Almost. Run up.
Give up. Give up.
Number one.
Two. One at it. Dusty stuff.
Ooh. Oh.
Well, that was bold.
Very bold. One, two. Oh, dear God.
Well, did not expect to see that tonight.
Two!
Or again with this.
Cover. One, two!
Not quite.
Oh!
One,
two, three.
Oh!
And Black ends it with the Demon's Plunge. That nasty, nasty flatliner of his.
That was a tremendous, tremendous match.
That was, but holy moly. Martin almost went the distance.
Yep.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, getting back to the tournament. A block match coming up, and we've got a good one coming, and we got a good one for you. It is going to be the Jazzman taking on Ata.
They have a tough act to follow, but they're both both tremendous hands. Ooh.
Jazzman sitting at 1-2 1-2 right now, while Ronan 0-3. Well, no, Ata is at 0-3. Ata definitely needs a win here tonight in order to get into, in order to stay in the game. Here comes Ata! Oh, Jazz opens up with a flurry of punches.
Ooh.
Shoot, hey!
Oh. Oh, going for an early roll-up, but Ata quickly throws the Jazzman off. They go. Oh, going for that early Scorpion Deathlock.
Didn't make him tap. But it probably did some damage.
Nice snap suplex by Ata.
He goes.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, Ata's coming back in with a chair.
Get a chance to use it, though.
Ooh.
Ooh.
One,
two.
Almost got him with that hand-springing moonsault assault.
Jazz going up top.
One.
Cover. One. Two. Oh! Cover. One. Two. Back and forth they go. Oh! Dear God!
A super kick into the breakdancing leg drop.
But I think Ava got out of the way just in time. Oh, there's the vertebra breaker.
Oh.
Oh, there's numero uno. He's got locked in.
Not quite.
Oh! Now he goes again from numero uno. Cover. One. Two.
Not quite.
Oh! There's another vertebra breaker. Cover. One. Two.
Oh, not this time.
Cover. One. Two.
Man takes down Ada.
Solid effort from Ada. Yeah, that was definitely a good match. Coming up next, in the B block, we've got the Nacho Man, Pedro Fernandez, and he'll be taking on Pac.
Latino. Chica, ¿tú quieres probar a un latino más? Salte de mi lado, cause I'm bringing the heat. Cuando todo se termine, si tú quieres yo regreso. I'm not scared of you, my brother, cause I'm Latin. Latino, Latino, Latino,
with an early Hurricane Rock. Nacho Man comes back with a body slam. Not impressed with the mind games. Versus Nacho Man.
Oh, Pac with a counter. Oh.
wrist lock does not get the submission. Keeps him up in the air. Backslide out of nowhere gets a win for Pac.
What a squash, ladies and gentlemen. Holy moly. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
There you are.
I'm here. I've been here. All right. Coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, we have the first match of our tag team tournament. And covering this will be Pro Super Japan's own Kiyoshi Kobata. And for this first round match, and possibly done intentionally to keep to keep these teams from killing each other right off the bat, considering what they've done to each other the last 3 weeks. But first, we're going to see the Brawling Brutes taking on one of our newcomer teams, hailing from WrestleStar. We've got Pentagon Jr. and we've got Phoenix, the Lucha Brothers. This is gonna be a hell of a fight.
Thrown into the corner.
Oh, wait, ladies and gentlemen. I just got word from Ortega himself. He's just declared that that if the that if the brutes, the Duncan or Gunway and Chase do not behave themselves for the duration of this tournament and cause another brawl with their animosity to each other, they will all be kicked out of the tournament. And their future opponents would have, and their opponents will either have a bye or a new tag team to compete against, depending at what point during these next couple of weeks they cause the they set off the fight and got thrown out of the tournament. So in other words, these three teams, after the chaos they've caused the last 3 weeks, need to be on their best behavior if they want a shot at those tag team titles.
Phoenix is up first.
Pentagon.
Oh. Damn, they're circling around. Both men down.
Ooh. Uh-oh. Oh!
What a hellacious impact. Amazing coordination.
Very. Again, Ridge Holland. He's fights up the double team. Oh! A bear hug!
But he gets out.
Lands the punch. Oh! Kobashi's down!
Drops in the corner.
Oh, roll up cover. One, two.
No.
Sling blade on Ridge Holland. Goes to work on the leg. No.
Oh.
Oh, jeez. Oh, no, wait. Butch makes the save. Hey-ya. Oh. Over, picks him up.
Let's see what they can do with this.
Oh!
Tag. Pendulum backbreaker.
Cover. One. Two. Cover. One, two. Oh! Out right now. Myself a double team. Oh, Dom's Junior to the outside. Oh. Junior, Pentagon Junior is not in a good spot, but here comes Phoenix to even the odds. Or not. Cover. One, two. Only two count, but good defense from Butch.
Oh, pendulum backbreaker.
Yeah! Oh!
Pile driver.
Pulls him over, cover. Hey, he's in the ropes though. That gives Holland a chance to back away, tag him Butch.
Yeah!
Oh! Oh! Pentagon gets dumped to the outside. Phoenix flies! Oh! Neck breaker! Cover! One! Ooh. Nice teamwork! The buzzsaw kick. Yep, drop the hold. Roll up. Cover one.
Right in his own corner. Oh.
Yeah! Ooh. Jesus Christ!
What a display from Phoenix. quite get the drop on Pentagon, but they do get the upper hand. It's the old Rikishi driver again.
Sling blade on Holland. Oh! Rolls him up. Will this do it? Number one, two. No.
Not quite.
Beautiful rotation.
Holland is getting savage.
That's an understatement. Cover. Will this do it? One, two. No.
If that power bomb softened him up enough,
tag it up to the Pentagon. Oh! Phoenix hits the double clothesline. Ladies and gentlemen, we've only got 2 minutes left in this tag team match.
Yeah!
And we are still not close to a winner.
Oh, what the hell was that?
Cover. One, two.
Oh!
Match.
Ladies and gentlemen. The first round of our tag team tournament has just ended in a draw. Okay, while we try to sort that out, we're bringing to you Homicide versus Ronin for the junior tournament. A block.
Tournament canceled.
Nope. That's what caused a riot if we cancel the tournament. Put a neckbreaker on Homicide. 5 minutes. Oh! Another overhead suplex. Good God. Oh, catches the foot.
Yeah.
Cover. One,
keep
two.
Thrown as far away from you as possible.
Suck in the...
That's an understatement.
Oh, misses.
Suck in the...
Oh! Tossed it to the outside.
Suck in the...
Oh, not quite.
Ooh, cover. One, two. Almost got him.
Do some damage to the leg.
Yep. Ooh! Moving over, picks him up. Oh!
LeBron pulls out the win.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next in the B block, we've got John Knox taking on El Hijo del Vikingo. We'll be right back.
Yeah! Oh, pile driver right off the bat. Strong start by Knox. Oh, takes him right out. Nails Knox in the corner. This is the backbreaking kick. Ooh, lariat, then a drop kick. Classic combination. Duplex one, out of the ring.
2, 3, 4.
Almost got him. Almost got Knox. Ooh, the Knox is delivering the damage.
Yeah. 10 minutes gone.
another elbow drop from Knox. Viking was not impressed. Didn't quite get the three, but almost. Takes down Viking.
I'm back.
Knox seemed to have El Hijo del Vikingo's number.
Coming up next, we got women's action. We're going to have John Coleman coming in to ref this one. But we've got Alexia Morse taking on Kaiva Romi.
Brawl. Rumble Explosion.
Into a sharpshooter right off the bat.
Give up.
Oh, what was that? It was like, Dawn. So, yeah, Dawn goes to the corner, like she's told her. Quietly watching.
Oh wow.
Damn. Did he destroy off the top rope? Cover. One, two. Ooh. Hey Centurious, welcome to the Global Wrestling Alliance. Glad you can join us. Right now we got in the ring, we got Mad Scientist Alexia Morse in the blue, taking on Taylor Rooney in the white and gold. Cover by Taylor, one, two. Damn Coleman, where the hell were you looking when you're making that count? They have their luck looking up like indie matches online and stuff like that, or maybe watching AEW. Or just watch EFEDs on Twitch. Or maybe even catch Japanese wrestling. I've seen a couple of those. I've seen a couple of Japanese wrestling matches and they are really, really good. Those sudden close to those weapons.
Yeah.
Nope. Wheelbarrow DDT Bulldog.
Oh! Oh, Dawn getting involved.
Ooh.
Right on her.
Right on her head. Oh, that is very awesome, James.
Oh, DDT.
Oh, she saw it coming.
Double one, two. And Gaven gets the win.
Nice. That's actually pretty cool.
Strong win by Romy.
Very strong, yeah. Okay.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, coming into our final two matches of this week's round of the Junior Heavyweight Tournament. So first, coming up in the A block, we've got Morty Takeshi taking on Ace Austin, and then in the B block, it'll be Orange Cassidy versus El Desperado, and then in the main event, the GWA World Heavyweight Champion Revenzo goes one-on-one against a debuting Kenno.
But first up, Austin versus Takeshi. Nope.
This is an exam. I'm sure you can't figure it out by now, but I mix real life wrestlers with original creations that both that I've made and then I have found in the Steam Workshop.
And not for nothing, I think I need to go through my original roster and rebalance a few things. I think they've been running a little too much over the real life guys. I mean, you need to walk through a lot of the movesets. I might have made the movesets a little too compatible with the fight style. And not like I've been going too much into, okay, here's the fighting style, what move should I give them, rather than, okay, here's the character, what move should they have? At one point, I just started going like that. Oh! Oh! Low blow from Ace. Yes! And the Steam Workshop. Characters! Matt, graphics, individual parts for like faces, hair, clothing, and whatnot, and movesets too. You don't really download arenas, you just kind of like download like ring aprons and like mat graphics and stuff like that, and to build your own wrestling rings.
But if you get into the modding scene,
oh yeah,
things get crazy. Terms of arenas and stuff.
Yeah, but Firepro has a hell of a creation suite. But you can also make your own moves if you're good, if you're good enough with that. And you look on the Steam Workshop and yeah, it's just a lot. Here's something funny. You missed the first round of what was going to be a tag team tournament to crown our tag team champions. And it was the Brawling Brutes, Ridge Holland and Butch, taking on the Lucha Brothers, Phoenix and Pentagon Jr. And it ended in a draw. They hit the 30-minute time limit, and we're just sitting here like, well, that happened. Oh!
We didn't actually say that, though, because we're not dipshits.
Yeah, we were, yeah, it was less will that happen, and more like... And it, but it was definitely match of the night, though. Those two teams, they were just beating on each other.
Jesus.
Oh! Cover, one, two!
Corner now.
Afterwards. Oh, big chop. Dominator from Takashi. He goes up top. Lands that 450. Beautiful. One, two.
Ooh. Doesn't quite get it.
Goes wherever he stops, only Takashi knows. Oh! Busting him open with that one. That might do it. One, two, three. Yeah!
I got him.
Man, damn it, will get anybody. Now, ladies and gentlemen, coming up next. Yeah. Well, no, you don't download from the Steam Workshop. You can just, you know, use whatever music you got on your computer. You know, you can probably rip, you know, probably get them offline. You know, rip them wherever you can. Drop them into Power Pro Wrestling World's BGM folder, and then you're good to go. But coming up next, final match. Final match of the B block. And it'll be El Desperado taking on Orange Cassidy. Wow, he came out quick.
Before things get too dicey. Slug it out.
Mizuki is down.
Ooh.
Cover one. Very funny, Sarah.
Up goes Cassidy.
Well, this is kind of funny. This has got to be a bizarro night, because we've got Hyper Convoy actually showing up at the start of the stream, and Sarah showing up at the end. Usually it's the other way around. Oh, big frog splash! Cover! One! Two! Eh, who am I kidding? Sarah's always late to the party. Oh! Roll up, cover. One, two. Big Spine Buster from El Desperado.
Mm-hmm.
And equally big dropkick.
Cassidy goes out again.
Two, three. Oh! Yep, cover. One, two! Hey there, Reaper! Welcome! This is Fire Pro Wrestling World, probably one of the best 2D wrestling games you'll ever see. And this is GWA Saturday Night Wrestling. Oh, big spear from El Desperado. Oh, those devastating kicks from Orange Cassidy. It's a miracle El Desperado's knees are still intact.
Somehow.
Oh, another big spear. Oh, vertebra breaker. Pulls into the ropes. Cover. One. Two! Ooh, almost got him. Counter! Another vertebraker from Desperado. Cover. One, two, three! And Desperado gets the win! Ladies and gentlemen, coming up next, it is your main event of the evening. Senior referee Samson Wayne will be refereeing this match. And we've got the GWA World Heavyweight Champion, the Witch Doctor Ravenzo. And he'll be going up against the one and only Kenno.
Be right back.
Let's get some betting going here on the main event, shall we? There we go. Oh, we got 350 on the champ.
Fight!
When I designed GWA, I always had like the 80s and 90s in mind, with, you know, these larger than life like comic book superhero characters and whatnot, you know? I mean, how else do you explain the fact that I have a Frogman on my roster? That's from France. And you know, we got witch doctors and, you know, guy who's known as the demon of the GWA and stuff like that. They got samurais in the form of Ronin and the like.
Whoa.
cover. One, two. Bigfoot stomp, Ken-O. Hey, about time, Ryan. What's up?
You missed a hell of a tag team match. Rolling Brutes versus the Lucha Brothers. Match of the night ended in a fucking draw. Right now, here we are in our main event. And we are seeing how well Ken-O can stand up to the world, to the GWA World Heavyweight Champion. Oh, he just laid him out with those kicks. Oh, going in for a triple eight ankle lock submission.
Like it's been an exciting match.
I'll say. Oh, another body slam. Oh! Chokeslam from the champ. Oh! One, two! Almost! If you can read this, I was forced to put down the controller and re-enter society. Ken-O is on a warpath right now. Oh, wait. Revenge with a counter. Cover, one, two. Oh. The crowd is on their feet for this one. Thank you.
exhausted.
Oh, and shit can to the outside. Kano follows. For once, yeah. Oh. That might do it. 2, 3. What a match, ladies and gentlemen. And what a match. Oh. Renzo showing once again why he is your world heavyweight champion. Kenno may have come up short, but this is definitely won't be the last we see of him. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of tonight's episode of GWA Saturday Night Wrestling. What a night. And next week, it's going to be even crazier. Because next week in the tournament, we've got Ace Austin taking on Ronan. We've got Orange Cassidy going up against John Knox. We have Jazzman versus Homicide. Pac versus El Hijo del Vikingo. We have Kane versus Eita. El Bo versus Nacho Man. Momori Takeshi versus Duke Fed. And El Desperado versus Akira Tozawa. Those are your matches for the Junior Heavyweight Tournament next week. And also for our second round match of the Tag Team Tournament. It will be the Duncan Brothers versus La Grenouille and the Canadian Crusher, Chase Ford. Oh, your points. That's, yeah. There you go. Yes, the Nacho Man, Pedro Fernandez. But yeah, that is the end of our show. I want to thank you all for coming. I want to thank Carr for always being here with me each and every week to call the action. Sure. No, he is not. He is not sponsored by Doritos. No, somebody's asking if the Nacho Man is sponsored by Doritos. But don't change that channel, because coming up in 10 minutes, WrestleCast Radio here in the Discord, our very own Ryan Cook, the technical legend, he will be streaming Pro Wrestling Summit. And normally he streams Friday nights, 11 p.m. Eastern, 10 Central.
But in order to stay on schedule, because I think, what, you had to take a week off, right, at one point? He's doing back-to-back shows this week in order to stay on schedule. So be sure to catch him for Pro Wrestling Summit tonight and more of his tournament, the annual S1 Grand Prix. And that's about it. So, yeah, have yourself a good night. We will see you all next week here at the GWA, 8 o'clock Eastern, don't forget. And until then, y'all have a good night. And this is Stas Varents signing off.